Close your eyes and watch your breath. Watch it all the way in, all the way out. Make sure your mind really stays here. Put some extra effort in today. After all, today is Visakhapuja, the day we commemorate the Buddha's birth and his awakening and his passing away, entering total nirvana. And as I said, the best way to show homage to him is through the practice. So sit down and practice. We take refuge in the Buddha as an example. The real refuge is what we find inside as we practice. And while we're practicing, one of the things that we have to protect with our refuge is our actions, in the sense that the Buddha gives a good example for how a person should act in life. The Dhamma gives instructions on how this is done. And the Noble Sangha has shown that it wasn't just the Buddha who could do this. There are many people over the course of the millennia who have been practicing this and gotten good results. So that's the outside example. But it's when you take it in, that's when the refuge becomes true. Because your most important possessions are your actions. It's one of the few things where the Buddha actually says is yours. Ajahn Sawat used to point this out. He said, so many things the Buddha says are not self, not self. And then you get to your actions, and he says, we're the owners of our actions. These are your real valuables. And so what's the shape of your valuables? If you put them out and took them out of a cabinet and put them out on the table, what would you see? We'd probably see a real mixed bag, good and bad, all kinds of things jumbled together. We've got to learn how to protect our actions. You know, the bad ones we need to let go, and the good ones we want to nurture, we want to protect. And so we protect them by remembering the example of the Buddha, the Dhamma, and the Sangha. Because they show us what human beings can do. They show us where real happiness lies, things of real worth. As the Buddha said, the real heartwood of the Dharma is the release that comes inside as a result of the practice. And that doesn't need protecting. That becomes your refuge ultimately. That doesn't need protecting when it's done. But to get there, you have to protect your actions, because they're the things that make the difference between whether you're going to get anywhere in life or we're just going to be sort of paddling around in a little tiny puddle, going nowhere at all. So ask yourself what you want out of life, what you're going to do with your life. Every year when events like this come around, I remind you, a whole year has passed since the last time around. What's changed in there? What's gotten better? Has anything gotten worse? If anything's gotten worse in terms of your actions, you've got extra work you've got to do. If things have been good, we'll try to maintain that goodness. Because the goodness of your thoughts and your words and your deeds, those things are your true valuables. You want to protect them as best you can.